Today in the news, we got some XT benchmarks, Intel monsters, and free performance for NVIDIA. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your Boot Sequence. Let's get started with AMD. We're a few weeks away from the Ryzen 3000 XT release, and we're already getting some benchmarks. Yesterday, Tom Apisak found some Geekbench runs for all three of the models. Just as AMD said, we can expect the improvements mostly in single-threaded workloads. The 3900 XT, for example, gets an improvement of about 5% in single core when compared to the 3900X, but only about 3% if not less in the multi-core test. There doesn't seem to be a higher all-core boost to those chips, since that would cause the multi-core score to be a lot higher. Thankfully, the refined 7-nanometer process that Robert Halleck talked about will allow the chips to reach their advertised boost clocks more often and more consistently. Also in AMD, it looks like Renoir is getting the Infinity Fabric treatment we wanted to see. Now, take this info with a grain of salt since it comes from the Chip Hell forum, but a screenshot of a Renoir APU has just popped up. It features an 8-core CPU running at 4.375 GHz, and the Infinity Fabric on this chip is cranked all the way up to 2100 MHz. This would move the sweet spot for memory up to 4200 MHz for the lowest raw memory latency possible, as long as the timings are right. In this specific case, the memory was running at 4200 MHz, allowing a 1-to-1 ratio with the Infinity Fabric. The timings were 17, 17, 17, 36, and once tested on IDA 64, the raw latency was 62.6 nanoseconds. As you can see from this chart, with the Infinity Fabric at 1800 MHz, 62.6 nanoseconds is great. It's especially beneficial for an APU since the VRAM is essentially your system memory. Now, I think that this specific fabric clock might be an OC, since the actual number we've been hearing in the rumors was 2000 MHz and not 2100, but either or would already be a pretty good improvement. The rumors say that these chips will make their first appearance in July with the XT CPUs, so we'll just have to wait and see. Moving on to Intel, their Xe GPUs just made another appearance on Twitter thanks to some pictures from Raja Koduri. In standard discrete cards, an engineering sample of the DG1 was pictured on a test board. Reading the tag tells us that this is likely an early version as it is marked with ES1 and with the revision of the board being A0. It also mentions 12x8, which refers to the 96 execution units, or EUs as we've come to call them. Other pictures of the lab were also shared, with one showing us a trio of high-performance computing, or HPC, GPUs for data centers. Those three models are likely the three we saw on a leak back in February, where we saw the tile system. The small chip would be the single tile version, two tiles is the rectangular one with double the EUs, and lastly, the big one would be the four tile version. If we go back to that leak, remember that the four tile version could consume from 400 all the way up to 500 watts. They also shared this photo of one of those chips being cooled. While we can't be 100% sure, I bet that this is the 4-tile version under there. It can only be the 2 or 4. It does look like the engraving reads Arctic Sound 4-tile Top Retention Assembly. Then we have NVIDIA and Microsoft in the news. Windows 10's latest update combined with NVIDIA's driver update gives you the option to turn on hardware-accelerated GPU scheduling for NVIDIA GPUs. This allows the GPU to manage its VRAM itself, which in turn could turn out better performance in games. Two outlets so far have tested the feature with some pretty nice results. WCCF Text Test with a GTX 1650 Super netted a nice boost in performance of about 5-10%. That's pretty insane, although when you look at GPUs with plenty of VRAM like A2080 Ti, GPU scheduling doesn't seem to have an impact. Matthew Conaster from AdoredTV.com tested the feature on his Zephyrus G14, which is equipped with an RTX 2060 Max-Q. It too got a considerable boost in performance, as you can see from these charts. It seems like GPU scheduling will give you a performance boost up to a certain amount of VRAM. Unfortunately, I don't have 10 different GPUs to test it out, but so far, up to 6 GB seems to have a nice bump in performance for the green team. As for AMD, the feature isn't currently supported, but an employee asked us to please be patient on Reddit. And that is pretty much it for the catch-up, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Drop a like if you liked it, a comment if you want to talk about today's stories. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video right here. To subscribe to the channel, stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care.